Gone are the days where you could set and forget your website and set and forget an ad that you ran in the newspaper. Those days are history. Right now, what every building company needs to do is continually improve their web presence, because that's how you're going to beat your competition. That's how you're going to generate new business. And that's how your conversion rate is going to continually improve year on year on year, so that you are a powerful sales engine and you're growing your building company. And today we're looking at continuous improvement, how you can look towards improving everything that you do incrementally, month after month, to ensure that you're going to stay ahead of your competition and continue to dominate in your business. So this is one of my favorite areas of what I call continuous improvement, because I think this is probably the most underutilized and probably the least respected, if I'm honest, from a lot of business owners and building companies. And I see them not utilizing continuous improvement to actually bring their costs down with what they're spending on advertising and marketing and their lead costs, bring that down while still improving your conversion rate percentages. So let's say, for example, you're spending $5,000 a month and getting 50 leads. If you do continuous improvement over time, you'll spend $5,000 a month and you'll get 60 leads. So those kind of improvements can be made across every level of our signature system. And I'll run through that really quickly now. Let's look at your ideal client. When you first start advertising, you might have a general idea of who your ideal client is, but as you start to generate leads and start to understand the market, you'll see that actually your ideal client paints a slightly different picture, even big builders. So when you start to see that, you want to change your ads to suit your ideal client, and you'll want to make some changes on your website to talk directly to your ideal client, and you'll want to change your marketing and email automation system and your CRM and the way your sales team speak to those ideal clients. So that's a way of continuously improving your ads, your website, your sales scripts, and your digital email. Looking at your brand story, this is something that will also continually evolve. Let's say you win a new award. You'll throw that on your ads, you'll update your website, you'll announce it using your email, and your sales team can also use that in providing a point of difference against your competitors. So your brand story will change and evolve. Let's say you bring on a new, really experienced team member, for example, you might want to announce that. Let's say that you open a new display home, or you just complete a beautiful luxury home. That becomes part of that brand story. So you evolve these things over time. Let's say when you start running your offers, you may have a bunch of offers that you initially start with, but you might find that two out of the three different offers that you have running really work well, and one of them just sort of lingers and doesn't do much. So you might update that offer, advertise it, put up the new offer on your website, announce it in your emails, and you are continuously improving those offers. When you are creating lead magnets to attract people, announce them in your ads, update the website, link them to your CRM and marketing automation software so that those lead magnets automatically get sent out and improve your conversion rates. The way that you communicate in your email system, you may find that certain emails like have certain headlines and certain copy that generates more inquiries than all of your other emails. So what do? You update your email marketing system, put that as a priority, and then perhaps go and revise the older emails that weren't converting as well as that one. Then you realize what people are clicking on, what people want to read, so you update that on your website. You go use that intelligence to go and change some headlines on some key pages because that's what people responded to. And then you create ads using those headlines from your email marketing system because those ads converted. Or let's say you just decided to run a very short-term offer, but you had a massive amount of conversions. Plug it in your advertising, plug it into your website, create a new page on your website and lean into it. With your conversions, as you start to convert and get better with your sales sales team, and as you start to hear different pain points, you then put that into your email system, update your website, update your ads with your calls to action. With your search engines, you want to continually evolve that search terms that you use. You want to use negative keywords. You want to get more marketing intelligence. You want to test your banners and update all of that information. When people are clicking on certain terms, you might find, okay, our quality score is quite low. We want to improve our quality score, which will lower your click cost, give you more money to spend on future ads with your existing budget. So you update your website, you make changes to those pages or introduce new pages to improve your search. If you're converting on certain keywords because of the search terms, you update those keyword phrases and start speaking to your audience with your marketing system. Or you also improve the ads, like I say, from your search engine. You make improvements to keyword phrases, you split test those ads to continually evolve. And as you find the winning ads and the winning headlines and the winning hooks in your ads, update your website, update your CRM. Same with social, exactly the same. You get high-performing ads, you continually evolve and split test the ads. The winning ads you then use for different web pages and different offers in your email marketing system. So all of this is integrated. This is having a look at your marketing system overall and making continuous improvements to all of these areas so that over time you win more business. Your website's a better reflection of what your customers want as opposed to what you've been putting out there. Your communication strategy through your email system is more tailored to your ideal customer. Your ads are more relevant and getting more click-throughs and more leads because you understand what your clients' pain points are and how you can help them and what offers they love that brings them into your company. So all of these things work together. So you can't ignore any one thing. You can't do this and think, I'm done. You're not done. You want to keep working on it. Keep paying attention to the patterns, like I mentioned in one of my earlier videos in this series, and you'll see general improvement across the board, across your ads, your website, your conversions, your email marketing, and your sales. I hope this has helped. I know it's detailed. I know there's a lot to think about, but if you think about it as an overall engine for your business, this is the way to improve it and win and beat your competitors and win more business for your building company.